Happy Sunday, Dreamland, and welcome to Sunday service. Are you ready and excited to worship God? Well, I am excited to worship with you. So join me at this time as we prepare our hearts for this time of worship with the word of prayer. Let's pray together. Dear God, thank you so much for giving us this time and setting this time aside for us so that we can worship you. Please help us at this time to remember that we are worshiping you and what a wonderful God you are. Help us to be focused on you. Help us to open up our ears to hear your word and open up our heart to give you everything. We love you so much, Jesus. We thank you and we pray in Jesus' name. And everyone says, Amen. Amen. At this time, as we go into a time of praise and worship, please join me by getting up on your feet and let's worship together.
Dance, 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 dance in the river. Dance, 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 dance. around it, around it. Your love is everywhere and I'm surrounded. It's got me singing, it's got me shouting. And now I wanna tell the world about it. Cause now I am alive, yeah, you opened up my eyes. Everywhere I look I see.
At this time, let's confess the Apostles' Creed in one voice. Ready? Go. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended to hell. And on the third day rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Universal Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Here are some announcements for today. We have our package pickup today at church between 12 p.m. to 2 p.m. Be sure to stop by and pick up your February packages. Also, please remember to stay in your car and keep your masks on at all times. We will be having a Zoom live service next week, February 7th at 11 a.m. So be sure to keep that time open. Come with an exciting heart to worship and fellowship together. We will see you then. That's it for announcements today. Now join us as we go into the memory verse for this month. This is the memory verse for January 2021. Let's read it together in one voice. Let us hold unswervingly to the hope we profess, for he who promised is faithful. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 23. Amen. Welcome to Happy Sunday Dreamland! Yeah! We're so happy to have you. Let's talk royalty for a second. So we know King Saul, the first king of Israel. We know a successor, or the king who came after him, which is King David. And after David came Solomon. Well, afterward, there was a whole lot of kings, right? Israel split into two kingdoms, North Israel and Southern Judah. The northern kingdom of Israel had a string of evil kings, And today's guest finds us during the time of King Ahab and his wife Jezebel. Are you ready to hear his story? Let's welcome him together at this time, Elijah! Thanks for being here with us today, Elijah. Could you please introduce yourself to our audience?
Sure thing. My name is Elijah, and I was a prophet during the reign of King Ahab.
Could you please explain to our audience what a prophet is?
Oh, yes. A prophet is someone to whom God gives the message, and his or her job would be to deliver that message to God's people.
Wow, that's so cool! So, what was the message that God gave you?
Well, so many of the kings leading up to King Ahab were bad too, but this time was especially pretty bad. King Ahab and his wife Jezebel had turned away from God and were worshiping Baal. Not only themselves, but many of the Israelites fell away from God too.
No, that couldn't have had a happy ending.
God was not pleased. So he told me to go tell King Ahab that a devastating drought was coming.
A drought?
A drought. It means no rain.
Well, that can't be that bad, right? I mean, it rained here a couple days ago, and that was no fun at all.
Well, it might seem like it, but during my day, and even now, rain is needed in order to live. Without rain, our crops wouldn't grow, and the streams and rivers would dry up, and then we would starve and die.
Oh, wow. I hadn't even considered that. I just thought rain was annoying.
Rain was so important to us, and telling King Ahab that there was a drought coming put my life in danger. So God told me to run away, and he led me to the brook Kereth.
Hold on. I thought that you said that the brooks were going to dry up too.
I did. But if God led me there, I had to trust that he had a reason and a purpose.
How did you even eat food?
God sent ravens to bring me meat and bread in the morning and bread and meat in the afternoon. And I got water from the brook.
Wait, ravens? Like, caw-caw ravens?
The very same. God sent those ravens to help me. But then the water dried up because, you know, drought. So there was no rain. So then God told me and sent me to the Gentile land to this widow who lived with her son.
She must have been really rich if God sent you there to provide for you.
Actually, she was very poor. All she had was a handful of flour and a little bit of olive oil, and she was about to cook her last meal for her and her son.
Well, what happened next?
Well, God told me to tell her to make me a small loaf of bread with the last of her flour and oil. And also that the jar of flour and jug of oil will not run dry. It won't be empty until God sends rain on the land. So she went and did exactly what I told her, and God kept his word. There was food every day for me and the woman and her son.
Well, happy ending!
Well, not quite yet. Sometime later, the son got sick and died.
Oh no!
The woman was so sad and asked me if I had come to remind her of her sin and kill her son. But I told her to just give him to me. I carried him to the upper room where I was staying, and I laid him on the bed, and I cried out to the Lord. Then I prayed for the boy's life to return to him. God heard my cry, and the boy came back to life.
Wow, what an amazing turn of events. Well, Elijah, what do you think that God has shown you through all of this?
I think that God really showed me that he is Jehovah Jireh, which is Hebrew meaning that the Lord will provide. When we trust in him and follow his guidance, God provides for us in ways that are amazing and out of this world.
Wow, I love that. Jehovah Jireh. Dreamland, can we all proclaim that together? Jehovah Jireh, the Lord will provide. Amen. Thank you, Elijah, for reminding us that our God always provides. Dreamland, I pray that you will remember this and be reminded that Jehovah Jireh, the Lord will provide.
Well, thanks again for being here with us, Elijah. And thank you, Dreamland, for joining us here on Happy Sunday, Dreamland.
Let's pray the Lord's Prayer together in one voice. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Welcome to Craft Time! Hey guys, welcome to Craft Time. Today is the last Sunday of January. It's already been a month. Wow, time sure does fly, huh? All right, so, and today, because we have the package pickup, we're gonna kind of make this pretty quick. There's not too much to explain, but I just have to show you a couple things. So, for today's craft, you gotta pull out this bag that says number 5 on it, right? So I have it. And in the bag, what you will find is 4 pieces. Make sure there's 4. One of them is really small, so. First thing is this, what is this? It's like this like plastic circle thing. Wait, is this like a cover? Oh, yeah, 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 okay. So yeah, there's that circle thing. And then there should be this like colorful, mine is dark blue, black. Pastor Bobby's is yellow. Are you distracted still? It's called a tassel. Tassel, right? And so you have this tassel, it's connected to nothing. It kind of looks like a squid, right? Then you have this keychain thingy, right? It's like a chain with like the key ring. And then the last piece, do not lose this piece, it's really important, is this tiny, this thing. This ring. It's just an open ring that's meant to close. Okay, today what we're gonna do is we are going to draw on and design these little keychains. We're gonna put it together and then it's for you to gift to someone. Gift to someone. So, I mean, you could make it for yourself, I guess, but then wouldn't it be even better if you just made it for someone else? I think that there's so much joy when you give a gift to somebody. Oh, so deep. So what you're gonna do is pull out this plastic thing, and today I assure you, no matter what age you are, you could be 31 or you could be 5 or 8, you are gonna need your parents' help. I will need my parents' help. I will need an adult. But what you're gonna do is first step,
peel.
Peel. There is a, it's really hard to see. So ask your parents for help if you can't see it, but there is a little plastic film. You guys see it? A little plastic film on top of it. I know, and then it should come out really clear. It's okay. Gives it character. Yeah, look at it, now we're super clear. It should be really clear. It's like glasses, kind of, right? You should have this clear thing. Okay. So there are so, I didn't give you anything to really like do with this, but there are so many things that, so many like different mediums or different like tools you can use to decorate this. What I am going to use and what Pastor Robbie is going to use is like this permanent marker, and we also have these paint markers. I think they have to be, this actually might not work because I just saw that it's water-based, but it might work. Okay, it's water-based, which means it'll get washed out by water. But, or another thing that you could use, I think permanent marker tends to do the best, but you can also use nail polish. Yeah, you can use nail polish. Or, that's all I can think of. It was nail polish, right? Nail polish would be really cool too. So if you can use whatever tool you want. I do wanna say though that you can, like permanent marker is the best, but if you don't happen to not have a permanent marker, you know, ask your parents to see if you have one. If you don't, and when you come to church today, you let me know, I will give you a permanent marker to use to draw on it, okay? So yeah, that's it. Today, pretty much, you're going to decorate this how you can. Fill it with encouragement, always, you know? Fill it with thanks and encouragement, and then like give it to your parents or give it to your sibling as a little gift, all right? So get to decorating and we will see you on the other side. Other side. Peace. And we're back. How did you decorate? Let's show it up here. What did you do to decorate? Yeah, hold it up. Let's show each other. Aww. Yours is so much prettier and like more intricate than mine, Pastor Foamy. There's a lot of green, but green is good. Green is a good color. Awesome, yeah. So once you've done this, now what you're going to, now this is the tricky part where you will 100% need to have your parents help you. So now what we have to do is we have to connect the tassel and the keychain to this ring and this, okay? So what you're gonna do, this part that you can do is holding the ring thing, okay? Holding the ring thing, you're going to slip in the keychain. So do you see how the keychain is hanging on that ring? And then you are also, on that same one, gonna slip in the tassel. So it should be like this together. Yep. Sir, how did you even do that? Oh yeah, I mean, okay, so you can do this too. Pastor Fabi, if you wanna show them, you can do this too. That's pretty cool. And then what you do is you take your, you take the keychain that you made, that you decorated, and then you stick it on that ring, oops. You stick it on that ring, and you might need, you might start needing your parents' help from here, actually. Okay, ooh! Probably, maybe what you did was easier. Let me see. Wow, good job.
Guys, don't use your fingers, it hurts. Use an adult.
Okay. And then, yeah, and then you're gonna bring it to your parents, and it's best to use a tool.
Yes.
Benji. Are what is it in English?
A wrench?
No, it's not a wrench.
Pliers.
Needle nose pliers work best, just because so that you can get it. But yeah, parents, please use needle nose pliers or Benji did, and close up the circle so it's nice and tight. And then you have this. You have your little keychain hanging like this. And then the next step is very important. You give it to somebody else. Give it to the person you made it for. Here you go. Yay. And that's it. Well, can you explain this for us? Because I feel like the green screen, it's not gonna show up. Guys, this part is green. But what is this, Pastor Fabi?
It's a tree by a stream.
That sounds like a verse we might know. Does that sound familiar? Maybe from Psalm 23? Yeah? 23. You lead me by streams.
Oh, awesome.
Oh, you were thinking of
Psalms 1.
Or Psalms 1. Psalms 1. It's great. But yeah, but that's it. Also, what might work, just like a side tip, it might be best if you, like, after you're done, no matter what you use, after it dries, to go over it with clear nail polish. And let it dry one more time. That way it'll kind of work as that like protective sleeve. Cool. But yeah, send me a picture, please. I love the pictures that you guys send. It's not as many pictures as when we first started doing these videos, but I still love seeing your pictures and I want to see it. Or if you do this before you come to pick up your packages, you can show me then. But yeah, definitely. I can't wait to see what you guys did. But yeah. I hope you enjoy it. I hope it will be a lovely gift-giving time. Yep, I love you guys. Have a great week. Stay safe, and we will see you next week.